Welcome friends, today we are going to discuss one of the application into drug discovery process, that is new drug application. It is required to approve by regulatory agency, that is FDA, to market your drug. Learning objectives: students should able to understand what exactly this new drug application, what are the contents of this new drug application, and what exactly the process of this approval of NDA application. Now we'll just go through this drug development timeline. This drug development process consists of different stages. Drug discovery screening is there. Then after drug discovery screening, drug is entered into your preclinical research. Average time period required to conduct this preclinical research is about 18 months. And after this preclinical research, we have to file one application, is known as IND application, to regulatory bodies, that is FDA. And then regulatory body will give you a permission by reviewing this application to proceed with your study. And when you approve with this IND application, you can proceed for this clinical study, means you can test your drug into the human beings. Then after completion of your clinical studies, you within 5 years you have to file this NDA application. Then after approval of this NDA application, you can market your drug. Okay, this is the general process of drug development along with this timeline. And we are going to discuss one of the application from this drug discovery process, that is new drug application. Now this new drug application is an application submitted to US FDA for permission to market a new drug product in United States. Goals of this NDA, that is new drug application, are to provide enough information to permit FDA reviewer to establish following things. One of them is safety and efficacy of your drug, whether your drug is beneficial or it is having some risk factor, that we have to prove. Then whether drug proposed is labeling appropriate or not, and what should be the content of label. Then are methods used in manufacturing of drug and manufacturing and control of drug to maintain drug's quality adequate to preserve drug identity, then strength, quality and purity. So these are the different goals of new drug application. Then fundamentals of this NDA submission. In fundamentals, quantity of information and data submitted in this NDA can vary significantly. The component of any NDA are a function of nature of subject drug, and information available to the applicant at a time of submission. Then the form to use for either NDA or ANDA is form FDA 356H, application to market a new drug for human user or as an antibiotic drug for human use. Then classification of NDA. CDER classify this NDA application with a code that reflects both the type of drug being submitted and its intended uses. That is new molecular entity means for which thing you can file this application. That is new chemical molecular entity, then new salt of previously approved drug, then new formulation of previously approved drug, then new combination of two or more drugs, new indication for already marketed drug, including switch in status to OTC, means that drug is already in a market, but you have found out that it is having one more indication along with this previously approved indication. For that drug, you can file this NDA. Then already marketed drug product without previously approved NDA. For these things, you can file your NDA. Then fundamentals of this NDA submission is given into the form FDA 356H, and this consists of 15 different sections, and these are the 15 different sections, that is index, summary, CMC, that is chemistry manufacturing control, then sample methods, validation packages, then labeling, non-clinical pharmacology, toxicology, human pharmacokinetics and bioavailability, then microbiological data, clinical data, safety update reports, then statistical case reports, then case report forms, patent information, patent certification, and other information. These are the 15 different sections of this NDA application. Then NDA requirements. Include content and format of application, then formatting and assembling and submitting a new drug and antibiotic application, then new drug summary format and content, NDA technical sections, then abbreviated new drug applications. These are different requirements. Now we'll see one by one content and format application. In this section, exact requirement are a function of the nature of specific drug. NDA must provide all relevant data and information that sponsor has collected during product research and development. Okay, and this all data should be recorded, and it is required to file along with this NDA. Then second section, that is formatting and assembling and submitting new drug and antibiotic application. This application is having a different formats. This NDA regulation require a submission of archival copy and review copy. These two copies required to submit along with this application. Now we'll see what exactly this archival copy and what is a review copy. Now this archival copy is nothing but a complete copy of application submission and is intended to serve as a reference source of FDA review. This archival copy acts as a reference for FDA reviewer, which will be review this application for approval purpose. This contains information which not contained in a review copy. This archival copy is having some extra information. That information is not available into the review copy. And second copy is review copy. It is divided into five sections containing technical and scientific information required by FDA reviewer. Okay, as per the regulatory norms, as per the regulatory requirement, different type of the information is required to collect, like technical information, scientific information, and that information is reviewed by this FDA reviewer. And in a review copy, different sections are there, and as per this section, information is collected. This review copy consists of a copy of cover letter, then copy of application form, that is 356H, then copy of overall summary of application, then copy of index of entire application, then index to specific review section, and both copies are submitted in hard copy to the regulatory agencies. Now we'll see six technical sections involved into this review copy. This review copy is divided into six technical sections. One of them is CMC. And each copy is recognized with specific color. The CMC copy having a red color, while non-clinical pharmacology and toxicological data bound into yellow color. Then human pharmacokinetics and bioavailability into orange color. Then microbiological data collected into this technical section or required to submit with this technical section, it is bounded into the white color cover. Then clinical data represented in light brown, then statistical data into green color. These are the different sections of this review copy. Now second part is assembling of this application. How can you assemble this application? It consists of folders, then papers. In folders, helpful to retrieve material which is collected into this application, and these applications are kept in it is necessary that applicant use a colored folder to bind the archival copy, okay, as represented into the sixth technical section. And as per the requirement of regulatory agency, color code is used for that specific data, and prepare a folder, and cover of each folder should bear a NDA number, name of this applicant and name of drug product is there into on a cover of each folder. Then second, paper size and binding required during the assembling of this application. Okay, all application must be bound on a left side of page using United States standard size loose leaf page. That size is 8x5 into 11 inches. That paper size is, only that paper size is used during this assembling of application. Then pagination, all pages must be numbered, and numbering of these review copy pages should be same as that of the numbering of corresponding pages into the archival copy. Means numbering into the both the copies should be same into review copy and into archival copy. Then volume size and identification. This volume must be volume submitted in hard copy form and should be more than 2 inches thick. Is that much data you have to submit. Then next part is packing cartons. Now this packing cartons, like box size, recommended for this shipment of the application to the FDA is nothing but 14 into 12 into 9.5 inches. Then supplements, amendments and post-marketing reports. Now the submission of the format for the amendment to pending application and supplements to approved application will be same as an application. Then for each application or each submission will consist of two copies. Now which two copies are there? A complete archival copy and appropriate review copy. These two copies has to be submitted. Then these amendments, supplements and a resubmission of annual report is there, and other corresponding information as per the regulatory requirement is required to submit by sponsor during this approval process. Then third part of this NDA application is nothing but NDA summary and format and contents. Now this summary should be sufficient detail. Data should be provided into the tabular form or graphical form, and you have to prepare summary within 50 to 200 pages. Now this summary part includes annotated package insert, and second one is pharmacological class, scientific rationale, intended use and potential clinical benefits of this investigational drug. Now this annotated package insert includes a proposed text of labeling for the product, and the text of package labeling must be annotated by the reference to volume and page number to the information in the summary and in a technical section of application. The second part, which is related with the pharmacological class, rational, scientific rationale and intended use, it include a statement which is required to identify your pharmacological class of drug, then scientific rationale of drug and its intended use, its potential, its clinical benefits, its pharmacological effect, that you have to report into this section. The next part is chemistry, manufacturing and control. Again, it consists of drug substance. It includes description of your drug substance, its physical and chemical characteristics, its solubility, its stability, then CMC of your drug products. It includes composition of your dosage form, which excipients you have used during formulation of dosage form, which dosage form is there, either it is solid oral, either it is liquid, either it is semi-solid, then name and address of that manufacturer, then container closure system. You want to select to from seal your drug, you want to pack your drug, then stability, then specification for drug product and test method to assure this specification, that data related with drug product you have to file into this section C of CMC. Then next section, that is foreign marketing history. Now if you want to market this drug outside this US, then regardless of this dosage form or strength, then its salt, its ester or complex of the drug, then marketing history should be provided along with this application. And it also includes list of the different countries in which you want to market your drug. Then it also includes any countries in which drug has been withdrawn for any reason related to the safety and efficacy. And along with this, you have to give a reason behind this withdrawal. Then non-clinical pharmacology and toxicological summary. It includes pharmacological study, acute toxicity studies, multi-dose toxicity study, then reproduction study, then special toxicity study, carcinogenicity studies, then ADME of your drug, then mutagenic property of your drug. That data you have to give into these non-clinical pharmacology and toxicological summary. Now next part is human pharmacokinetics and bioavailability summary. In this section, you have to give this brief description about the bioavailability of drug, then pharmacokinetic characteristic of your drug and dissolution profile of your drug. Then you will come to know that how much drug is bioavailable. Then next section, microbiological summary. Now this type of the summary is required to give if your drug is antibiotic, if your drug is anti-infective and antiviral, then this microbiological summary is required to submit. This microbiological summary should include mechanism of action of that particular anti-infective or antiviral drug. Then what is antimicrobial spectrum of that particular drug. Then also you have to give mechanism of resistance of your drug along with this microbiological information. Then next section, that is clinical data summary and result of statistical analysis. In clinical data summary, efficacy and safety that will determine NDA approval of your drug. Then clinical data summary and results of statistical analysis are divided into these several parts, like clinical pharmacology, then overview of clinical study, then controlled clinical studies, uncontrolled clinical studies, then safety summary. Okay, these type of the data are included into this clinical data summary. Clinical data summary is nothing but your summary of whole application still from drug discovery. Then fourth section of your NDA application, that is technical section. And this technical section includes CMC control, chemistry manufacturing control, then non-clinical pharmacology and toxicological data, then human pharmacokinetics and bioavailability section, then microbiological data. You have to give brief description for all these points in your NDA technical section. Then sample methods, validation and labeling, case report forms and tabulation, then patent information and patent certification. What exactly is patent information? This patent information is nothing but it is information that must be submitted regarding any patent held by a sponsor that covers the drug substance, formulation and composition of your drug product and method used for the formulation of that drug or drug product. Then after approval of this NDA, this information is published into this Orange Book, and approved drug product with therapeutic equivalence and serve as a guide for wishing to develop these generic copies of your investigator product. Then last part is patent certification. Now patent certification means when receipt of NDA approval received by sponsor, then FDA conducts a review of this application and its completeness within the 60 days of your filing of approval. After 60 days or within 60 days when you file your application, and FDA either accept a filing or send this applicant a refusal to the file. Means file either it accepted or refused. Now we'll see a process of drug approval. Okay, sponsor first of all file NDA application, then this fileable application reviewed by this CDER from medical, pharmacology, chemistry, biopharmaceutical, statistical and microbiological point of view. Then one advisory meeting is there after reviewing this information into this NDA, and this advisory meeting with this sponsor review complete application and approve it. Okay, but if sufficient information is not there, if your application is not fileable, then it is refused immediately and informed to the sponsor. Okay, after the review of your CDER, complete review of application is there. Okay, first of all, your application is reviewed by CDER, and then it proceed for this complete review. If this complete review is acceptable, then applicant would ask to submit safety report within 4 months after initial submission. Okay, if this complete review is not acceptable, then additional information it has to be given by your sponsor to this regulatory body. Okay, and this information is submitted in terms of amendment. Okay, if it is okay, then again a complete review is there and this complete review is accepted. Then this complete review include labeling, review acceptable, then inspection of site, then pending satisfactory results, labeling, review acceptable and inspection of site. All these things required to accept by this regulatory body. Okay, if labeling review is not acceptable, then it is informed to revise this label to the sponsor, and that information again submitted to the regulatory body. And if this inspection sites are not acceptable, then pending satisfactory results are there, and that has to be modified by the sponsor. Okay, if everything is okay, if your CDER committee approved your drug, it is entered into this complete review, and then this complete review is acceptable, then your NDA application is approved by regulatory body. Okay, in this stage of FDA will send one of three possible actions and letters to the applicant. Now which three possible actions will be there? First, application not approval letter. Okay, if deficiencies are there into the application, and then this application is not approved by this FDA, and why it is not approved, it is explained into that non-approval letter. Then second possibility is an approval letter which indicates that ultimately the drug product should be approved, but lists minor deficiencies and labeling changes that are needed before approval. Okay, means they are suggested some changes. Okay, this approval NDA application is approved, but minor changes will be suggested by these regulatory members during this review process, and that has to be done by the sponsor. Third possibility is an approval letter. It states drug is approved. An applicant may receive both approvable letter and approval letter. And the division director of CDER sign this application and approve a letter. The product can be legally marketed and starting on the date. Okay, means when it is approved, then it is able to market. Okay, this is all about new drug application, which is required to approve by regulatory agency to market your drug.